Hi, my name is Sajid Ajmal, and I'm affiliated with Quick Start Intelligence since last 5 months. Today, I will be demonstrating on how to provision a SharePoint Server 2016 form. I will explain the steps very easily, and hopefully, you will understand it with a positive note. So, the first step in order to configure the SharePoint Server 2016 form is to configure an account in the Active Directory Center. Currently, I'm using the virtual machine, and in your scenario, you might have Active Directory system at one place and SharePoint Server at different place, and the domain controller at a separate place. So, in order to demonstrate you, let's hop into the first step, that is configuring the Active Directory account for configuring the SharePoint Server 2016 form. Okay, so let's start the Active Directory Administrative Center. Okay. Over here, the Active Directory Administrative Center, we have multiple areas. We have to click on Contoso Local. Contoso is my organization name. You have configured the Active Directory based on your organization name. So click on Contoso Local, and there are multiple organizational units available over here. I have to configure it based on the Information Technology unit. I will click on IT, and then New You, and then User. Once you open this, you will provide the full name as SharePoint Server Form, and in the user UPN logon, SP Form. Remember that this user UPN logon will be provided once we will be at that stage of configuring the SharePoint Server Form in the products configuration wizard. So remember this name which you specify over here. Password, you can select any password of your choice. I am selecting of my choice. And in the other password options, select password never expires and user cannot change password. After that, click on OK. Once the OK button is pressed, we are done with step number one. No need to do anything further in this Active Directory Administrative Center. The next step is to configure the SharePoint protocols. SharePoint form is basically, it follows SQL Server TCP and IP protocol, and in order to configure that, we have to enable it. Since I mentioned earlier that I have multiple systems at one place as I'm using the virtual machine, I'm going to switch to the database server. In database server, I will configure the protocols for SharePoint form. I will open up SQL Configuration Manager. And over here, we have protocols for MS SQL Server. Enable this TCP/IP protocol. Press OK. After that, in order to make these changes in effect, we have to restart the SQL Server services. So select Restart. Once the services are restarted, the TCP/IP protocol will be enabled. And now we can see the service has restarted. Okay, now we have to set up client network utility configuration. In order to set the server alias name, we will first go to Windows. And System 32 over here. I'm sorry, we do not have to configure the network connectivity, client network utility over here, we have to connect it in SharePoint server. So select SharePoint server. In your case, you will go to the SharePoint server and then go to Windows System 32. In the System 32 folder, search CLI CONF. This is the client network utility configuration executable file. Over here, you will specify the name of the server alias. Select the network libraries as TCP/IP and the server alias as Contoso DB. In your case, you can provide your organization name and the name of the database. And my server is located at NYC DB1. Press OK. Again, press OK. We have to configure this client network utility server alias name at one place also as well. And that will be in SysWOW64 folder. SysWOW64 folder is located over here. Search the same client network utility. Click on open alias. Add it. Select the TCP/IP protocol. Server alias is Contoso database. And my server name is NYC DB1. You can specify your name in this section. Your server name. Sorry, not your name, your server name. Press OK. And then again, OK. Client network utility is configured. Now the time has come that we have to configure through the configuration wizard. So for that, we will open SharePoint configuration wizard. SharePoint products configuration wizard. Once it will open, it will show us a welcome page. Here it is. Click on next and accept this yes. Since we are creating a new server farm, we will select the new server farm. If you are altering or modifying any changes in the server farm, existing server farm, you will select the first option. So we will go with the second option right now and click on next. Database server name is Contoso database and username is that name which we specify in the Active Directory Administrative Center. So remember I told you that you have to remember this name because we will use that name in later stage. This is the stage which we will specify that name. So that my name, my domain name is Contoso and the UPN logon name was SP Farm and my password was this. Click on next. Enter the passphrase. PA. This is the same as entering the password. Whichever password or passphrase you want to specify, you can specify over here. I prefer specifying the same password which you specified in the previous step just to handle the passwords collection easily. The more collections of password, the better chances of forgetting it. So same password. Click on next. Specify server roles. There are many different types of server roles over here, like multiple server farm, front end, application, distributed cache. We will select the custom farm because we are creating a new farm. Click on next. Over here, specify the port number on which your farm will run. The TCP/IP protocol will run on this farm, which will be, I specify 50,000. You can specify other port number, whatever you want to specify. Don't change the security settings. Select the NTLM and click on next. Okay, these are the settings which we have specified. So click on next and your configuration will start to configure. Remember that this step will approximately take around 15 to 20 minutes. So grab a cup of coffee and donuts and watch the game. Once this process is completed, your farm will be successfully configured, and then you can enjoy the privileges of it. Hope you have enjoyed the video. Stay tuned for the next videos. Thank you.